Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Nova Spirit Tech, and today I want to see if I could fit a PCIe into an M.2 module slot. Now that requires me to convert M.2 module key M to an M.2 module key B and M. So let's get started. All right, so one of the hardwares that we're gonna be using is from Banggood. They actually shipped out this unit for me, and I'll leave a link in the description. It's only $10 for this whole PCIe setup, which this allows you to connect to an M.2 module M key slot, which I don't have on my Udo x86. So here's a little bit of a backstory. What I'm trying to do is get a GPU working on my Udo x86. It has an M.2 B key module slitted in there right now. So the only thing that fits in that slot would be a B key or a B and M key. And the only other PCIe extension board that I found was only for the M key, which means that it's gonna be missing that groove to slide into the actual connector. So if you take a look at this SSD, it has two grooves and it slides right in. Now, if you take a look at that module key, the M key, it's missing that groove and I can't slide it in. If you sand it down a little bit, you should be able to flip it over and slide it in. Now, I tried it this way, but nothing works. Obviously, it's not. So my hopes is to actually convert this M key into a B key by cutting out the section that it's not needed. If you take a look closer to the M key, I'm not using any leads to those pins. So if you take a look over here on the right, you're gonna see that these leads are going into the actual USB port. And then on the left side, there's nothing there. So in theory, I should be able to cut that out and get rid of that groove, and I should be able to slide it into the B slot. Again, in theory, it should be able to boot up. Now, I did my due diligence in searching all this stuff, and the web doesn't have anything like that. I haven't seen anybody convert an M key to a B and M key. So this is, I guess, the first. And to be honest, reading about the pinouts and all that stuff on the connector, it should work. But I could be completely wrong and blow out my board. I don't know. But again, this is what we're all about. So let's get started. I'm going to start cutting this up and see what happens. All right, so the first thing I did was mark out the section that I want to cut out. And then I used a pair of really small dykes to snip the two joints. And then I bent it back and forth until that chip fell off. Now I realized that it's not deep enough, so I ended up taking a file and just file it down until I create that groove, the U-shaped groove. Now everything looks like it's in place, and then I tested it against the other board. It looks good. And then now I'm going to try it against the board itself, the connector, and see if everything fits in place. Once that's done, next thing is to do the testing. All right, so I actually have the connector connected to the M.2 port, and it fits fine. I didn't screw it down yet, but that should be okay. And then I have the pressure of the board just keeping it there. That is connected to this thing right now. And I have an old 5450, you know, something that doesn't take that much wattage, so I could power it off this 20 watt, you know, this is for hard drives. So this should be able to power this guy just so I could get it initialized. Now I also have an HDMI hooked up to this monitor, and this guy is hooked up to this monitor. And yeah, here goes nothing. Let's try this out. All right, now I got this powered. And it's powering that right now. And I'm gonna plug in the power for this. I boot it up into my Ubuntu. Quick LSPCI should be able to display if I'm able to see this display. I really don't see anything here that's related to that. Let me see if I could get a D pipe that into grep and look for VGA. Nope, doesn't look like anything that has to do with ATI. All right, so that was a big bust. Nothing is displaying on this screen anyway. But power is going through, because if I unplug this, the screen goes no signal. So that's how I know power was going through. But as soon as I connect it, the screen goes black. no signal instead of not connected. So I know power is getting through, because if I unplug the power, it would basically say it's not working, I believe. Let me see. Unplug the power. Okay, I lied. But yeah, I'm not seeing anything. Alright, I'm going to play around with this to see if I could wiggle the wires or do something, but I'm doubting this project right now. There's a chance that it's not going to work, and I did all this for nothing. So, let's see. Alright guys, so I played around with it for another hour or so, changed out power supplies just to see if I could power the board differently, all of which still didn't work. So, my theory in converting a M key to a B and M key, absolutely busted. I really thought it would work, because the pinouts and everything would have worked. Oh well, if you guys enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. If you guys want me to test something out of the ordinary, hit up in the comments below. If you guys are new to this channel, consider subscribing and also hitting that little bell notification icon so you know when the next video is going to be out. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.